And it is for the United States Championship.
Okay, so the United States Championship Open Challenge, the title defended inside the squared circle, of course, but in a extreme rules match, not inside an extreme rules match, but that's a stipulation. Pay-per-views always grab the biggest superstars to challenge John Cena.
Introducing the challenger from West Newbury, Massachusetts, weighing in at 251 pounds, he is the United States champion, John Cena.
However, of course, I mentioned that pay-per-views grab the biggest superstars. You've got to look back at Monday Night Raw. If you miss that, go back and check it, episode 8. Oh, wow, you missed. If you haven't seen it, like I say, go back and check it out. I'm not going to spoil it for you, but what an open challenge. I mean, of course, it wasn't successful, but the charisma of the challenger, that's a little hint there. But a shock return now. Who will challenge? Well, let's go. Oh my God! It can't be. It is, surely. We know that face anywhere. The vigilante is here. The icon, Sting. The face of WCW made his debut at Survivor Series 2014. His in-ring debut at WrestleMania 31, being defeated by Triple H. He had a world title match against Seth Rollins at Night Champions 2015, in which he got injured. And he's back, making his debut in Universe Mode, and he's returned to WWE, and he points a cricket bat. It's not a cricket bat, it's a baseball bat, apologies there. But he points the baseball bat at John Cena. Sting, challenging for the United States Championship. Is it possible we could see a title change chance tonight? Remember, this match extreme rules. And we know Sting will use any weapon he can in terms to win. We saw that WrestleMania just came short against the game.
For years, Sting was the cornerstone
now
of WCW.
The match begins. Sting with a side headlock takedown. Shot to the top of the head. And the challenger leaving the ring straight away, going under the ring. Now, what weapon does he come out with? Sledgehammer. Possibly sending him. No. I was going to ask if we could have been sending a message to Triple H.
Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one.
Now shot across the back from John Cena. Cena has dominated the title for so long now. We've had an open challenge every week.
And I'm sure we'll be able to see the handprint left by that chop.
Our truth has come closest so far to ending the reign of John Cena.
Look at this. There is absolutely no
kick to the midsection. Neckbreaker and the sting of the icon. Once again going underneath the ring. And he grabbed a steel chair. Cena blocks it and throws it away. Drop kick to the back of the head. And Sting may have only had 4 matches in WWE. He may have a 50%, you know, a 50-50 win-loss record.
Can't help but think of the most memorable matches he's given us over the years and what were some of the biggest events
that Sting
WWE has ever staged. I mean, maybe none bigger.
Sting is
Unforgiven in 2006. He turned the wrestling world on its
There's just no way to describe Sting.
Oh, out of nowhere.
And there's a knee to the head reversal. Shot to the head.
Well,
and now the elbow connects.
One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you could find yourself in a world of hurt.
Another elbow. You got to think.
Oh, man, Michael.
Pre-Night of Champions Raw, Sting had two matches. Won both. One by disqualification and one by submission after he made Seth Rollins tap out to the Scorpion Deathlock. Now, elbow to the head once again, and he picks up the steel chair. And then just a steel chair across the stomach of the champion.
Attitude adjustment from the top of a 16-foot ladder just before he claimed the title. That's probably something we'll never see again.
Now, Cena with a clothesline.
And we're back to this
kick to the midsection.
Yes, we are.
Who will win this match? Snap suplex on the concrete. Sting needs to be careful not to aggravate the injury that he sustained at the hands of the Architect.
Back into the ring.
Now.
Yeah, this is good. This is where the action needs to be. We were talking about the unbelievable tables.
Sting. Reversal. The double leg takedown.
No, not again.
Now stomp to the chest. Repeated. Now Cena leaves the ring. Back in straight away. Another kick to the midsection. Cena with a reversal. And the punch rocks Sting. And now to the outside goes the challenger, and the champion follows.
Kane, think about the number of WWE Hall of Famers that have held the United States title. No doubt the US Championship is a very
And now the elbow
title,
reversal. Sting with an atomic drop.
To go home with it.
Well, you're right, Michael. You'll fight your
And again.
To try to become the United States
and
champion
Cena
here at the
goes down.
It's such a prestigious title to hold.
Now, Cena with a back suplex, connecting on the outside, and Sting getting punished now. Maybe thinking to himself inside, you know, God damn, I shouldn't have accepted this challenge.
After a move like that, he's going to need to see a chiropractor or a spine specialist. Whatever he's comfortable with. No pun intended, of course.
The fans, I can't believe
I'd say that's more embarrassing
that Sting is back.
Anything else?
Well, we're on the move here.
And now off the ring post goes John Cena, head first. Now again the chair shots.
End of story. This one's
dominating Cena with the chair once more.
This one's gotta be
oh, and now the Luthes press. The multiple shots to the head, John Cena.
And what a reversal from Sting.
Now, reversal. Now you got to look at Sting with a neck breaker.
Now you have to stay on top of your opponent.
Sting down. Both men down.
We all know what they say about karma.
Sting looks hurt.
Ooh, that did it. Well, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake.
Now Cena. Cena on the receiving end of such punishment from the challenger. We all thought the challenger on Raw would have something somewhat of an effect on Cena's title reign, maybe even end it. But dominated throughout the match, he was defeated. And Cena carries the title through to tonight.
That strike hit the spot. There's no way.
And in this episode, see if I can remember. Episode 10. No, 10? Episode 13, I believe. Part 3 of Extreme Rules. We have three title matches. And this the start, and what a match, what a beginning to this we have. And our main event features another return of another legend, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, defends a WWE World Heavyweight Championship in a leg drop across the throat of John Cena.
Sting using his speed right there. I'd say that's more embarrassing than anything else.
Now into the ring apron.
One moment of hesitation.
And now Cena taking the chair to Sting. Reversal, however. Reversal by Sting once more, blocking the chair shots. Sending Cena crashing into the ring apron. Not once but twice, as you see there. One of these guys is going any chance of a match getting in the ring and ending in the ring rather than just fighting on the outside? Because no matter how much you dominate, no matter how much you punish on the outside, you cannot win outside of those ropes. Now off the steel ring post goes the Vigilante. Cena catching his breath there. Now again, so off of the ring post.
Baltimore. In fact, it was in this city that superstar Billy Graham defeated Bruno Sammartino for the WWE Championship.
Just going around in a cycle, Cena just throwing Sting into the ring apron. And now, punch, sending Sting onto the announce table.
This is John Cena's moment. And there's the reversal from Sting.
Can Sting knock off the 15-time world champion? Not yet to go back to the ring, at least.
Once again, the United States Championship is
now assaulting the legs, possibly setting up for a potential Scorpion deathlock later in the match, which could, if he does lock it in, could end the match, causing Cena to tap out, which is a very, very rare occasion. And now back in the ring, finally we go. Oh, reversal.
Nobody controls the
pace. Oh, catching the leg. Belly to belly suplex. Now an elbow drop to the back of John Cena. Cover now. New champion, could we? One, two, kick out at two. And the leader of the C Nation stays alive. And remains United States champion for now, at least.
Some damage has been dished out, but certainly.
And a Stinger splash in the corner.
How much damage did that do?
Looking for a new champion now. One, two, kick out at two. Cena staying in this. How? How is Cena staying in this? Sting. Can't believe it. The WWE Universe can't believe he's going for the Scorpion Death Drop. Scorpion Death Drop. Sting looking for his first title in WWE. One, two, three, no! And Sting, with a look of amazement, I apologize if you're wearing headphones, but this match, Sting, close, so close, going for a second Scorpion Death Drop, go for the cover, Sting, one, two, three, Sting has dethroned John Cena. Sting is the new WWE United States Champion. The face of WCW has just beaten the face of the WWE, the face of WCW, has just won a title from a 15-time world champion. May not be the world title, but Sting with his first title in WWE. There you see the Stinger splash. And everyone looked at the past superstars that have accepted the challenge, the returns, and they probably looked at Sting and thought, They probably looked at Sting and thought, well, same thing's going to happen to this guy. He is not going to win. But
let's take a look, get some of the big highlights.
But this Scorpion Death Drop, the second Scorpion Death Drop, and this three count says otherwise. What a start to episode 13, and what a start to part 3 of Extreme Rules. Because Sting is your new
WWE Extreme Rules
United States Champion.
An exciting night.
The crowd on their feet for the vigilante. The crowd on their feet for the legend, the United States Champion, Sting.
The following contest is an Extreme Rules match, and it is for the Global Championship. The man called Sting. The man called Sting. John Cena.
And she just gets weirder. But we are back with the phenomenal G Championship. Roman Reigns gets set to defend the title that is held for nearly a month now. So she on SmackDown, she said it's for the Global Championship, Bad News Barrett. Now, I've explained why it's called the Global Championship. I'm not really sure myself as such, but it's just because anyone can hold it, defends it anywhere, and it's got, like, yeah. So she says, the man called Sting twice, the new United States Champion. The first ever title change in Universe Mode. And then she mentions the former champion, John Cena. None of them are anything to do with this match. Bad News Barrett was nothing to do with the match on SmackDown, yet you constantly repeat the names of other superstars. However, I would be more shocked if she said, oh wait, Seth Rollins. I completely forgot. This is a mystery challenge, and Seth Rollins, the architect, former world champion, is a challenger. I was in the middle of a rant about Lillian Garcia, but Seth Rollins, the man, the future, is here. And that future is once again now. Can Seth Rollins pull off a victory here? We've already seen one title change. Can we see another? Sting with a hard-fought victory over John Cena. Can Seth Rollins grab a hard-fought victory over Roman Reigns? This title, remember, defended every week, every episode on SmackDown. But we may have just seen the end of the United States Open Challenge.
After weeks of talking about it.
Okay, so it's time. The phenomenal G Championship is on the line. And guys, remember, up next, following this match, the main event. You know it, the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar, takes on the father of Natalya, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Jim the Anvil Neidhart acquired the title at the start of this series. However, he could lose it tonight in his first ever title defense. He was literally just given the title. We'll just leave it at that. But now,
he can get on that mat and wrestle. He can brawl. He can soar through the air.
Roman Reigns sent off the ropes and drop kick.
Actually, let's talk about both competitors. They clearly know
the challenger.
This match, and both came into this match in tremendous
now choking
condition.
The life out of the champion. Both superstars, former world champions, both were part of one of the most dominant forces, one of the most dominant trios in WWE history. Both were members of The Shield. And together, they were tag team champions.
Pouring on the aggression, the Rollins and all of his ability represents the future of WWE. All of the success Seth Rollins has experienced is only the beginning. If you don't believe it, just
now,
ask him.
Roman Reigns with a German suplex.
Roman Reigns
taking lessons from Brock Lesnar. The man who was repeatedly beat down Roman Reigns. Now Reigns sends Rollins off the ropes, catches him, looking for the electric chair, which does indeed connect, and Rollins doesn't seem to be much of a threat to Roman Reigns at the moment. However, with a jawbreaker. Now, there's a falcon arrow.
What makes Roman Reigns such a lethal entity is he possesses the power to dominate an opponent of any size.
And now,
to add speed to his attack in a ferocity that makes him a relentless instrument of
Rollins with a knee to the side of the head of Roman Reigns.
The strength, the agility, and his unyielding intensity.
Remember the jumping knee which broke the nose of John Cena. Now with a cover, one, two, kick out at two. Roman Reigns staying alive, keeping his championship, keeping, holding on to that championship with his fingertips, and now super kick. Now the cover, one, two, kick out at two. Roman Reigns surviving the scare for the moment. Leaving the ring now. Roman Reigns going under the ring. Now going for a table. No, that's not a ladder. You can't, only you can stand on it. That's only if you're pissed at like family parties and family do's and shit. But Rollins now. Kick to the midsection. Now the headlock lets him go, release him, forearm. Now an uppercut, the champion, Roman Reigns. Oh, reversal now, catching the leg. Now sweeping the leg, and now going for the single leg Boston. Single leg Boston Crab. Now Roman Reigns reversal. Now boot to the face. Shrugs Rollins away. Net breaker on the outside, Roman Reigns.
Behind everything he hits you with. He's simply reminding him that he's here.
Front face lock on the outside. What's he got planned? He's going for a snap suplex. Which does indeed connect. I also want to point out, I repeatedly mentioned that my career mode will be returning. However, I never deliver on that. And a standing shooting star press. Absolutely amazing from Seth Rollins. But I never deliver on my promises, and I've decided it's time for me to stop promising, and it will return whenever it returns on the channel, basically. And Roman Reigns sent bouncing off of the ring apron.
Well, Roman Reigns has achieved that, and then some.
And again, there we saw this multiple times.
Daniel Bryan, Reigns spear bisects his opponent and stops them dead in
the saw that multiple times throughout the Cena Sting match.
Look how slow he is to recover here. That was some serious punishment.
Now, Roman Reigns punched to the back. Now with the head scissors. Oh, reversal by Rollins, turning out of it. Now, what's he got planned? nothing there because it's a reversal by Roman Reigns. An elbow to the head. Now, Reigns sends Rollins into the corner.
It's one of the most awesome sights I have ever witnessed. With every step, you can see the intensity and rage.
Now he seats Rollins on the top rope.
And in mere seconds,
oh, reversal.
Heads up.
And now a crossbody from the top rope.
If he keeps up this pace,
now reversal by Roman Reigns. Punch to the head. Snapmare takedown. Now with a working headlock. Wrenching on the neck. Pulling back. Now can Rollins get out of this?
Championship on the line. Well, you're right about that. Let's get this thing going. Who's going to be the champion? Sometimes I feel like
Reigns just
to articulate
lets him out of it now.
Roman Reigns' spear has on one of his adversaries, or should I say...
And now belly-to-belly suplex, and the referee got caught with by the leg of Seth Rollins.
Awesome. Well, Michael,
and he's knocked against the ropes now.
From Roman Reigns has someone who's 6'8 and 265
pounds. I mean, there's a big shoulder block by Seth Rollins, the referee now, moving out of the way. Now going for that super kick again, and Reigns busted wide open. Roman Reigns wearing that crimson mask, and I do not actually know what he's going for. And there is a swanton slingshot type move. Now, what's Rollins going for now? Phoenix splash into the cover now. 1, 2. No, the kick out at 2 by Roman Reigns and the champion. The champion staying alive. Somewhat a mirror of the John Cena match. Now with a snapmare takedown into a headlock of his own. But the John Cena match was quite like this. Sting dominated a quite large portion of the ending of the match. Cena kicked out of one Scorpion Death Drop and the Stinger Splash, to which Sting went on to hit a second Death Drop and get the 3 count. But Rollins struck with 2 of those super kicks, a Phoenix Splash, and Reigns still managing to kick out. Now to the corner goes Reigns. Now perch him on the top pro. What? No, Rollins. No. What? No. Holy shit! Rollins with a huge superplex to the outside, and I think Reigns might have landed on that table. Reigns may have landed on that table at ringside. And now with a scoop slam, sit out scoop slam there, body slam, whatever you want to call it. Seth Rollins. Roman Reigns, I don't think he knows where he is. He landed pretty badly on the concrete. I saw him go to perch him on the top rope, I didn't actually know what he was trying to do there. Now Rollins just wrenching the neck, twisting the head.
Seems like these guys are letting out a lot of pent-up frustration tonight.
Now, will this match return to the ring? Oh, there's a great kick there. And now another standing shooting star press on the outside. Now there's a couple of punches. Oh, reversal! Samoan drop by the champion! Showing that there is still life in his body. And now there's a punch by Roman Reigns. Kick to the midsection. And Rollins with the knee! To the nose! And it's not enough that he's busted open from that second super kick, but he might have just broken the nose of the Phenomenal G champion. And there, the backdrop. Throwing Rollins over his shoulder and now picking him up. And there's a punch there. Favory turn by Rollins. Reversal there, and now flatliner. Roman Reigns trying to build more momentum. I can sense this match drawing to an end. And now another sit-out. The sit-out scoop slam. Rollins now twisting the head once more. Last time I checked, your head wasn't really supposed to bend that way. Now, I can sense this match on the verge of being over. While the Roman Empire could be coming to a close.
Here you have to be able to think on your feet. Lightning. One moment of hesitation and you could find yourself in a world of hurt.
Now Rollins back at Roman Reigns with a kick to the gut.
Big trouble here.
Irish whip into the corner.
Whoa, whoa.
He's going for the pedigree. Pedigree connects and surely we have a new champion, but he can't capitalise. Both men down as a result of the manoeuvre. Go for the cover, Rollins. Go for the cover. He's there. Pin him. One. Two. No, the kick out again at two. Surely, surely. Surely Roman Reigns has got like one beat left in his heart and he's got... Oh my God, and a spear out of nowhere. One, two, three, and Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins deserved that win so much. Out of all the challengers, Bray Wyatt, Daniel Bryan, and whoever else, Rollins put up the biggest fight. And not even then could he get the win. Not even there could he get the win with the pedigree. Rollins deserved that win so much, and all it took was that one spear. That one spear, and one, two, three. Seth Rollins is done. If I am honest, Roman Reigns is lucky to stand with that championship. And you just know that if he keeps putting on performances like that, that one superstar is going to come along and take that title from him. Seth Rollins, great performance, unlucky result.
The following contest is an Extreme Rules match, and it is for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
What, no? No Seth Rollins, no Roman Reigns, no? Okay, whatever. Okay, so it's time for our main event, guys. It is here. The WWE World Heavyweight Championship match. Extreme Rules, Brock Lesnar is here, minus Paul Heyman. Brock Lesnar minus Paul Heyman. Paul Heyman not eligible to be at ringside throughout this match. Now you'd suspect Lesnar looking for a big victory tonight, looking to regain the WWE World Heavyweight Championship, in which he was screwed out of by The Undertaker at Battleground last year. Now as we await the arrival of the champion. Here he is. The WWE World Champion.
From Reno, Nevada, weighing in at 281 pounds, he is the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
Jim the Anvil Neidhart makes his return, his in-ring return. Out of all the people, however, to give the title to, why Jim the Anvil Neidhart, you ask? I don't know. I just do not know. Now, Jim the Anvil Neidhart makes his, well, has his first match in a WWE ring for, well, a long time. Don't know what, must be what, 20 years? 20 years, maybe a bit less, I haven't got a clue, but he's ready for this match. The Extreme Rules match as well. And the Beast, struck with a backbreaker, goes for an early cover. One, kick out at one, the Beast. Could have been shocked there.
Gotten real mad. I think you're right, King. And that could mean some serious.
Could have been a shock on the cards.
You know, even when he was just starting out in WWE, Brock Lesnar was already a champion. He came straight off an incredible college career where he won.
Now,
the
off the ropes goes Brock Lesnar.
And just 2 years after that, he was.
He missed him there completely. Front face lock.
Lesnar wasted no time making the leap from
he leans Jim Neidhart across
beast.
On the ropes. Now the Irish whip.
Oh, wow.
Huge clothesline decapitates the champ. Jim the Anvil Neidhart putting up a bigger fight than I originally thought.
Lesnar wide open here.
Now Lesnar in the corner. There could be a massive upset on the cards. Not often you see Brock Lesnar defeated. He's only been defeated since his return to WWE by three men on three different occasions. Now he's going for the Kimura lock. Going for the Kimura lock, guys.
Great hold being applied.
Will he tap out? No, because it's a reversal there by Jim the Anvil.
No way he could have avoided that blow. And it's Jim the Anvil Neidhart with a reversal.
But now, as I was saying, he's only been defeated by three men since his return. Now, John Cena Extreme Rules 2012. Triple H, WrestleMania 29,
and, it's moves like
and The Undertaker at, oh, no, he won that match. Well, no, he wasn't pinned, but I wouldn't really say he classed it as a straight up loss. But he was also defeated by The Undertaker at SummerSlam, in a match which had a very, very, very poor ending.
The list of victims that the Beast is subjected to that move is like a who's who of WWE greats. No one is immune to it. If his back wasn't hurt before, it certainly is now.
And it's going to be hurt
and now.
Well, the
Jim the Anvil Neidhart sends Brock Lesnar into the steel ring. Ringside barricade. Apologies there. And
the
attacking the back and just
there.
Dropping
this
him.
Jim Neidhart becomes,
oh! And there is an arm drag by the
this
Beast incarnate.
Been so
and now four-way slam connecting.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Going for the power bombs.
Now
we've seen so many times before here.
Ribs like that can make it hard to
power bomb. Sorry.
All the names on that list of Brock Lesnar's F5 victims, the one that stands out the most to me is Big Show.
The Suplex City Chance. Ring around the arena. The Roman Empire continues, and this could well become Suplex City if Brock Lesnar has his way. And there's a suplex. Another suplex. and a third suplex. Goes for a cover now. One, two, kick out at two, and Jim the Anvil Neidhart still with his title in his hands.
The F5 Brock Lesnar performed on the big show at the Royal Rumble was a spectacle, the likes of which
they're flipping
ever seen, but
Brock Lesnar.
Earlier you alluded to the other legends, the Beast. There's the camel clutch.
Now camel clutch. Can the Beast, will the Beast tap out? No, he will not. Not yet have we had a submission victory on Universe Mode. And in one night where we've had our first title change, we could also have our first submission victory, and there's a suplex.
There's some serious power right there. He's setting up
by Jim the Anvil Neidhart, and he's setting up for something now.
Looking to put an end to this one.
And now, what's this? And a big slam there.
Makes him pay for all that. Oh, there it is.
And it could be all over for the Beast. One, two, and the kick out. The Beast stays alive. And this is, well, it's not all the type of, the sort of reaction I was expecting. The sort of match I was expecting, the sort of fight I was expecting from the Beast, and I've just repeated myself about five times, but never mind. And the Beast now building momentum. The Kimura now, he's got it singed in effectively. Got the legs hooked.
And there's the release.
He lets him out of it.
I'm scared.
The Beast now with the cover. One, two, kick out of two. Now,
I guess he's done with
Brock Lesnar with a snapmare.
Yeah, what's he gonna do next?
And now with a working hold, with a headlock now, wrenching back on the head and the neck.
You know, you're right again, King. That laugh of Neidhart's is frightening, but even more scary is the fact that you never know what he's thinking. He's just so unpredictable.
Yep, Bret Hart can attest to that. I don't think he ever anticipated a day where his own brother-in-law.
Now, side dressing leg sweep. By Brock Lesnar.
Like this, there are few.
Oh, and a reversal now by Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Apologies there. Two, kick out at two. The Beast stays alive, and the championship match rolls on.
The monster Brock Lesnar, nothing will.
Jim Neidhart, part of the legendary Hart Foundation, the Hart Dynasty.
Somehow,
trained in the Hart family dungeon. I don't even know if that. Brock Lesnar doesn't need any of that because he is the mayor, the prime minister, the president, the king of Suplex City.
When Brock defeated Kurt Angle in one of the greatest.
Now two backbreakers
to win the WWE Championship.
Now, and he picks up Jim the Anvil.
Hey, he's going for it again.
Going for a powerbomb. Connecting. And he holds on. We've seen this plenty of times before. And with the third powerbomb, you would expect would come the end. Now, do we have a new champion? One, two, three. Yes, we do. Brock Lesnar is the new WWE World Heavyweight Champion. And on a night where we have had one championship change hands, we have a second. One legend wins a title, one legend loses. Jim the Anvil Neidhart in his first ever title defense in Universe Mode. His first ever match in Universe Mode. He is defeated by the Beast incarnate Brock Lesnar. We have a new United States champion in Sting and a new WWE World Heavyweight Champion in Brock Lesnar. And what a night it has been here at Extreme Rules. Episodes 11, 12 and 13, part 1, 2 and 3.
That was a spectacular performance.
Kevin Owens making his debut in Universe Mode. I've said it so many times, making his debut on the main roster in Universe Mode, apologies. Nikki Bella retaining her title. And there we see the three power bombs. Roman Reigns retaining his title. The Lucha Dragons and Primetime Players, will they continue their feud? Same with Paul Heyman. Bad News Barrett and Chris Jericho. Bad News Barrett, Chris Jericho getting the victory in that match. And here's the 1-2-3 for Brock Lesnar. All of which will have drastic effects on the coming months in WWE. I want to thank you for joining me. Combined thanks to the last three episodes. I want to thank you for joining me for Extreme Rules. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for more 2K16 Universe Mode. New champion, Brock Lesnar. Thanks you as well.